Hello and welcome back to Florida Foodie. I'm Candace Campos and we have our producer Thomas Mates here with us. And today we are welcoming a veteran food truck owner, and it's a good food truck.
Yeah, and by veteran we mean that literally. He spent 15 years in the Marines before retiring and opening his own business. We are so happy to be joined by Joel Dawson from Brothers-N-Arms BBQ. How are you doing today?
I'm doing good, man. How you guys doing?
We're doing great.
Yes. Awesome.
The food, you could smell it from like down the hall. This is a beautiful spread.
Yes, ma'am. Mm-hmm.
So barbecue, is it just something that you've always loved? Is it something that you had a late love for?
Well, barbecue, you know, food service is what I did in the Marine Corps. Mm-hmm. I had an opportunity before I retired from the military, from the Marine Corps. My dad had a barbecue stand he was working for with our cousin. So I was talking to him about it, like, Dad, I want to do that too. You know, I was telling my friends, I want to do a food truck. And he taught me exactly how to manage a food truck, how to cook it, how to season it, and how to make it happen. And this is where we at today.
And this is where it is. And so you're a veteran. So can you tell, first off, thank you for your service.
Thanks for your support.
And I mean, what did you do in the Marines? Give us a whole breakdown.
So I joined the Marine Corps in 2001. And I always had a love for cooking because my mother and my aunts and my grandma and my grandparents, they always cook. My mother showed us how to cook at a very early age. You know, she like, you know, son, you're going to have to survive for yourself. You're going to have to cook for yourself. I'm not going to always be able to cook for you. Either you go to college, you go to the military, you're going to have, you know, you need to know how to cook. So when I joined the Marine Corps, I became a chef. I joined the food service community. And I did food service community, and they taught me how to do recipes and how to multiply them and feed the masses, over thousands. And the magic is to cook this food right here, mm-hmm. and the same mac and cheese, it was taste when the last 1,000 or 2,000 or 3,000 person eat it, it would taste the very same when that first person ate it.
That's
what the trick is. That's the trick. And that's what the Marine Corps showed us, how to produce mass quantity of food at a quality rate. And since then, I did, in the 15 years of Marine Corps, I managed dining facilities. I was able to go to Afghanistan a couple times, and I did food service for there, feeding for the war fighters, the guys that go on the front lines had a test of fortitude to kick in doors, take names. And when they come back and they come back successfully, they can come back to a great meal. The thing about food, and this is the key, mm-hmm. the thing about food, it boosts morale. Mm-hmm. You may have a bad day today, right? But if you can come, you know what, I'm going to go to my favorite food spot, that's going to boost my morale to a whole nother level. So think about the warfighter that goes out to the front lines of Afghanistan or Iraq, and they come back and they got some awesome barbecue, or they got a crab boil, or they got steak and lobster or surf and turf. They could come back to some good food. I know when I get back to the chow hall, the dining facility, I'm having some good doggone food. They can be dirty as all outdoors, but when they come in there and they sit down, and you can see the reactions on their faces. Like, they defeated when they walk in that door, but when they eat that plate, their morale is boosted. And I took that recipe that I see from the Marine Corps and from the military, and I do that with my truck each and every day. When a person tells me in the time I'm at their event, and I'm still serving, and they already ate their food, and I still got a line from here to down the street. Sir, whatever you did with that food, that was awesome. I want more of that. I'm getting back in line. That was good. That means I'm doing something right. And that's what I take, and I take pride in my food. It's not about the quantity. It's about the quality. And I think right now I master the quality of food to produce for the masses. So that way everybody can say they was in my line for an hour or 2 hours. They got the great quality. And they can tell me, you know, sir, it was worth the wait.
What are the most, because you said you were in Afghanistan and everything, what are the most like adverse conditions you've had to cook in?
Man, let me tell you, Afghanistan 2005.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I was scared. I did not want to go. I called my mom, like, yo, mom, I got to go to Afghanistan. You remember, you know, September 11th happened 2001. Mm-hmm. I was in Fort Lee, Virginia for food service school, as a matter of fact, learning how to cook in the field. Learn how to cook in the field and how to produce the recipes and how to follow the recipes, how to read. My gunner Sergeant Townsend say, if you can read, you can cook. That was his method. You read, you can doggone cook. Follow the instructions, Marine.
Okay. Yeah.
Learning how to cook in that adverse environment. I mean, they had rounds going off, you know, people yelling at you, screaming at you. I was in Afghanistan. I was on the border of Pakistan. And this time we wasn't in war with Pakistan. Mm-hmm. So you couldn't fire into Pakistan. We couldn't mm-hmm. fire because that we wasn't in war with them. Rules of engagement. Mm-hmm. So I'm in Pakistan. I'm Jalalabad, Pakistan border. We in a valley. So we already, you know, have a disadvantage because we're in the valley. I'm in the chow hall, and the chow hall, you see how slow the heat is?
Yeah.
It's terrible. Yeah. Imagine being in a mud hut with six propane burners inside a building, mm-hmm. and you cooking rice, you cooking like chicken, green beans, vegetable. Mm-hmm. I'm talking about, it was so hot, my camouflage uniform got a tan. Mm-hmm. That's how hot it was, you understand what I'm saying? So we got everything, you know, and you asked me earlier, like, yo, bro, how you cooking this heat, bro? Listen, I've been in Afghanistan too many times, mm-hmm. and you got to produce food. It's no excuses.
Yeah.
Marines have to eat, mm-hmm. you know, military personnel have to eat. So this particular time, you know, we're at the Pakistan border, and we're cooking and we're just having a good time. Special forces come in, the Marine Corps, Mark Sock come in, you know, the who's who that mm. goes in, you know, really special operatives.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? They come in and they got the beards. They look like they blending in.
Oh, yeah,
with,
yeah.
You know what
like
I'm saying?
Out of a movie.
They're real cool guys. You yeah. know what I'm saying? Yeah, they coming yeah. in there. And there, I say, okay, once they're there, you know you're good because if something really happens, something hits the fan.
Yeah.
I'm standing behind him.
Yeah. We're good.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So this particular time, we're in the chow hall, and I would say from this table outside of that door, a RPG went off. Shook the whole building. It was so intense that it blew out all the windows that were in the DFAT. Oh, and everybody that was sitting at the DFAT left their table, left their trays, and we all went to our, you know, to the bunkers. Mm-hmm. The grunts went to did their thing. I told my Marines, I had 10 at the time, hey, listen, follow me, grab your weapon. If they give us instruction, this is what we're going to do. Mm-hmm. That was the most intense. It was 45 minutes that we were in the bunker waiting for, you know, we're cooks.
Yeah.
You know, but every Marine is a rifleman. But they say, hey, Dawson, get up. You need to man the wall. Mm-hmm. I got to do what I need to do.
Yeah.
So after the 45 minutes, the lieutenant, my lieutenant said, we all clear, this and that. The grunts did what they needed to do. The snipers went up. We went mm-hmm. back in the chow hall like it was nothing ever happened.
Oh, okay.
And they like people's like, this is my plate, that's my plate. And I say, yeah, I can redo it again if you need to. Mm-hmm. If we got another if they do it again, we'll go back to it. You know what I mean? And that's what I'm thankful for. Marines is gonna be Marines. Mm-hmm. You know? So that was definitely an experience. That's one experience I'll never forget.
Yeah. So you retired after how long?
I did after 15 years.
Wow.
They had the option in the military to say you can retire early. I was tired after deploying so much.
Mm-hmm. How many times did you deploy?
I deployed four times.
Four.
And you know, ship, you know, Afghanistan twice, doing a MU, that's when you go on ship and you do different ports, but we still war fighting, you know, yeah. we don't know what they're doing because it's secret squirrel stuff, mm-hmm. but you're still doing something that's, yeah. you know what I'm saying, mm-hmm. support and defend, you know, the country. But I was just tired, you know, when you get older, you know, get a little older, mm-hmm. and now you're babysitting a little bit because you got younger Marines, and now you got the millennials that's coming in, you know what I'm saying? So, yeah, you know,
sorry.
Like, get off your phone, we got to work, you know what I mean? So it was just challenging, just, you know, doing all of that, and I was like, you know, I'm burnt out because you can only do, you know, your body going to take so much, you know, mm-hmm. PTing and running, yeah. you know, we do it all, shooting. Mm-hmm.
Along with the cooking.
Yeah, uh-huh. which is okay. all up
along
down,
with it.
Carry the sack of potatoes over there, start peeling, cutting,
exactly.
chopping, burn it's, yourself, cut yourself.
Exactly. Yeah. It, you know, and the thing with the Marine Corps is, suck it up, buttercup, let's go. You know what I mean? And that's what my mentality is now. You know, I tell my kids, just suck it up. You'll be all right.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You did you die?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Let's keep carrying on. Let's keep pushing forward.
Such a military
you know,
man.
You know? Yeah. And that's what I bring to my business. Mm-hmm. You know, it's been a lot of adversity that happened with my food truck. A lot of different things happened. My truck almost burned up. Car was caught fire. Then my generator didn't work. My car didn't start. But it's always you got to figure out a solution.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of people get stuck where I'm done. No. There's a solution to every problem.
Yeah.
You just got to figure out what solution it is. Mm-hmm. Maybe solution A may not work, but B or C may. Mm-hmm. But we're going to figure out before I leave here, this it's going to be fixed.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And that's what I take in my business. Yeah, I may take an L today, but I take a W tomorrow.
Exactly.
You know?
So you retired, and then mm-hmm. did you just hop right in? You knew this is exactly what you wanted
well,
to do? Or
I retired, and my thing was I got to get into corporate America. That was my mm-hmm. thing. I need to be a productive citizen.
Okay.
I got to be productive. I got to get a job. I had my wife, I say, listen, we were dating at the time. I say, listen, I need to hook up a resume. I've been in, you know, the Marine Corps for too long.
It's intimidating.
you know, yeah. it really is. I need to build a resume. This is what I did. I gave her everything that I had. This is what I've done in the military. Boom, boom, boom. It's just, all right, let me tweak it. Mm-hmm. So I got a job at Spectrum. That was my first job at Spectrum. And then that was interesting because it's a lot of people that like that whine about things. Yeah. And I'm like, why are you whining about that, man? Just clock in and do what they ask you to do.
Right. Mm-hmm. It's hard for you to understand that. Right. From where you came from. Just,
and
right.
You know me, I'm like, yo, and I can't do that because I'm not in charge anymore.
Right. Yeah.
So I had to take a step back. I'm not in charge. Mm-hmm. I can't tell people what to do anymore. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? They don't work for me.
Yeah. Until now.
Until now. So I worked for Spectrum. That didn't work because the schedule was crazy. Mm-hmm. I worked Monday, have Tuesday off, and then work Wednesday, have Thursday off, work Friday. No, I need a schedule. That's not going to work for me.
Yeah.
Friend of mine told me about Staples. Mm-hmm. I worked for Staples until we got we got laid off. Mm-hmm. But the whole time I worked for Staples, I was still working with Brothers-N-Arms. I was doing catering. Mm-hmm. So every other Friday, I would bring my, I would do orders and have my partner bring in 50, 40 orders of barbecue to them. And then I was catering their work functions. Mm-hmm. So I was working for Staples and still working for myself at the same time.
Yeah.
The job disbanded. I said, thank God, because at that point I was getting busy. Mm-hmm.
Gave you the opportunity.
The opportunity. People were like, man, you're not upset? Absolutely not. I'm about to work for myself full time because I did what I needed to do to work for myself. Mm-hmm. At that point, I knew that I needed to work for myself because I'm my own boss and I can't tell people what to do. At the point, Staples wanted to make me a manager and this, no, because mm-hmm. I know who I am and I'm too gun-ho. You're going to say I'm too gun-ho.
Good for you.
You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Because I was overachiever. They say, you need to do this, this, that, the third. I'm going to go and clock in and do my job. You know what I'm saying? This is what you pay me 8 hours to do, and I'm going to do it.
Yeah.
It's like, you want to be a leader? No, I've been a leader of people for 15 years. Mm-hmm. I just want to sit here and be told what to do.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So then after Staples, we got laid off. Mm-hmm. Then I start working, doing my own thing with Brothers-N-Arms.
And so how long ago was that?
I retired 2001. No, I joined 2001. I retired 2017. Mm-hmm. I retired 2016. In 2017, I started Brothers-N-Arms BBQ.
Okay.
And in 2018, we got January 1, we got laid off. Mm-hmm. And then I started going with.
Okay. All right.
Full-time.
So a few years that you guys have been doing this.
Yes. Yes.
How have you felt like the military? I guess you know.
Yeah.
Helps you with the food truck world. I mean, it's one of those things. It's a complete different shift in your brain, you would think.
Right.
But maybe not.
It is, but it ain't. You're dealing with civilians. You're not dealing with Marines. You can tell Marines, shut up, here's on your plate, and go forward, do great things. You know what I'm saying? I learned from military is how to multiply great quality of food and give it to patrons, give it to customers, you know? Just the whole, I took the whole architecture design for the Marine Corps from ordering, because I was with ordering. How to, if a person tells me I have 200 people in my wedding, I know how much to order of ribs, how much to order of chicken, how much to order for baked beans, mac and cheese. I put down my little equation, my form that the Marine Corps showed me. Okay, I need this amount of cases of this.
Brilliant.
And hit it every time. Mm-hmm. My business partner's like, bro, how do you do that? Listen, when they tell us this how many people we need to feed when we go out to the field, you do not ever want to be short. I always do over the amount. So that way you may have Uncle Tommy that wants some extra ribs.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I got him covered.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Always, I never want to meet it right on the nail. Mm-hmm. I want to be overage.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So the Marine Corps taught me exactly how to plan properly. Proper planning prevents piss poor performance.
Ooh. Mm. Well, I gotta write that one down. That's a good one. Yeah.
What's the biggest difference for cooking for civilians versus cooking for Marines? Is it just that they have the opinion and they can come back to you?
They have the opinion, man. They really do. They could tell you they can cook mac and cheese better. Uh-huh. Or I would do this when I cook it. Or when I cook my stuff, I do it this way. Well, and I, in my back of my head, well, open up your food truck. Yeah, right? Open up your business. Yeah. With Marines, you could tell them, like, shut up, get out my line, and keep it moving.
Keep it moving.
You know what I'm saying? Matter of fact, change your MOS to food service, then you can come show us how, what you made of. You know what I'm saying?
So show us. So this is some of your spread, this little sample plate.
Yes. So this right here in the middle is what we call our freedom platter. So we have a catering tray, you know, the aluminum trays that you put in chafing dishes?
Yep.
But it's a lot bigger. This is a little mini version of it. So
just
we have
for us.
Yes, for guys. So I have our award-winning ribs, which I won an award by with Darden, with our ribs. I have our slow smoke chicken. I have our award-winning pulled pork. This is my award-winning mac and cheese, collard greens, and baked beans all in one platter.
All in one platter.
All in one platter. It's called a freedom platter.
Freedom platter. That's fantastic.
Yes.
And so where are you? So your food truck is... Where do you guys normally hang out? Where do you guys frequent?
So now we're located in our base hub is in Sanford, Florida at Rockin' Rhonda's. We're partnered up with Rockin' Rhonda's Neighborhood Bar in Sanford, Florida. The address there is 2617 South Orlando Drive. You can catch us there every Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. We'll be there unless we have a special engagement that we'll be at. But right now we open up our backyard kitchen. So that way if the food truck moves, we'll still have the barbecue on site. So we're in Sanford as of now.
Wow. How much of a staff have you been able to like cultivate in just the past couple of years for yourself?
Staffing? I have my meteor guy that got me prepped. Yeah, as you see, you met him earlier, Lewis. He's great.
Yeah.
He has got me a lot of different events, man, when it comes to glamorizing barbecue. I never think I could take barbecue to the another level until I got him on my team. And the funny story, I met him at an event.
It's beautiful.
You know, and he said, this is how you need to plate it. Mm-hmm. And then ever since then, he said, bro, that don't look good. Do this. He could be a pain in my side sometimes, but it's all about succession.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And then I have my camera guy that you guys met. Mm-hmm. And I have, over the time, I had maybe four or five cooks. One of my favorite cooks, he joined the military. He joined Army.
Oh, congratulations.
He joined Army. So he always wanted to be his own person. Mm-hmm. But he was a great, fabulous cook. I hated to lose him, but I always talked to him about the military. You know, he wanted to join the Marine Corps. Some things happen, but I say, listen, look into the Army, you know, and I say, we're brothers in arms. Either way you go, you'll still be a brother to me. Mm-hmm. And he joined the Army. So at one point I had maybe like eight employees at one time. And each and every one of them believe in the brand. And it's all about teamwork. I tell people, I treat my business as the military. Mm-hmm. I may have a fire team. I may have eight people that's under my charge. But I treat them all as if they're a partner with me. Like, we're not on the same playing field, but I respect you. Mm-hmm. I respect you, you respect me, and we make the mission. Mission accomplishment is key.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. If we don't accomplish a mission, we didn't do anything right. So we always have to remember mission accomplishment is imperative. People don't know how we accomplish the mission. We can have so many different setbacks and drawbacks to get to the mission accomplishment, but nobody will ever know.
Mm-hmm. And I mean, and that's when us talking to all the different chefs and owners with Florida Foodie, it's not always an easy road. It's not just like we go from point A to point B and we have our own business.
You would like it for it to be like that.
Yeah, we'd love it. Then everyone would be doing it. But it is, it's quite a road.
Yeah,
it is.
And I tell any person that's getting to the food service business is tough. Mm-hmm. It's really tough. You gotta have a niche. And one of our things is when I met Lewis, he said, you gotta have a niche. I already had a niche before he even came to the team. Mm-hmm. We have a thing called a barbecue Sunday. I should have brought it out here.
And I wanted to ask myself, you about the Sunday.
I'm kicking myself in the butt about it. So the barbecue Sunday is a layer of baked beans.
Yes.
A layer of mac and cheese.
On top of each other.
On top of each other, layered.
Okay.
A layer of collard greens, and you get your choice, either pulled chicken, the pulled pork, or ribs on top. So.
And how big is this bowl?
It's a 16-ounce bowl.
Oh, wow.
A healthy portion.
How did you come up with that?
On accident.
No, you didn't.
On accident. So my dad, he's like, hey, listen, my son, my dad helped me get into the business, like I told you. So he's like, hey, you don't want to waste plate costs. So use a bowl. So I had a bowl at this one particular event in Daytona Beach, spring break.
Okay.
So I had a bowl at this point in time. I had the see-through bowl so you can see the layers. Mm-hmm. At this point in time, I just had a bowl. You can see it. So I had a layer, and I had the pulled pork on top. And I'm just eating it because we were getting our butts kicked. One of the girls like that knew was like, what is that you eating? I was like, little barbecue sundae. She's like, I want one. So I relayed to the team, like, listen, I need you to make this, what I just made, to her. She ordered four of them. walked around the area, and we sold maybe 150 of them.
No.
Wow.
So that's been a staple menu on our item. That's been a hot item.
You just wanted a moment of peace.
Yeah, just to have everything in one, because that's how I eat it, you know?
Yeah.
And lady's like, I want cornbread on top of mine. Mm-hmm. So that's, you see the cornbread, and put the cornbread. She's like, can you crumble it up?
Yeah. Of course.
Because women. The women love the barbecue Sunday because they get the barbecue experience.
Mm-hmm. But dainty.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They don't get their hands dirty.
Correct.
Yeah. Right.
Because barbecue is not a first date.
It's a messy sport.
It's not a, yeah, it really is. So if you can just,
right.
Yeah. Yum.
Right.
Okay. All right, you got me hooked. So can we try some of this?
Just do it.
Okay.
Dig in.
Normally Lisa is the one to be like, okay, we're trying this. Yeah. So now I'm like, can we try this?
Absolutely.
Oh my gosh. All right.
Yeah, I don't know.
So what would you say kind of, you have some type of drizzle. What is
that's our camouflage sauce.
Camouflage sauce.
Yeah.
I get it.
Yeah.
Seems on brand.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. So what's the camouflage sauce?
It's a mustard-based sauce.
Okay, I'm gonna try some.
Along with a complement of our tomato-based sauce.
Okay.
So it's going to be dancing on your taste buds.
I'm trying to be dainty.
There you go. Be dainty.
Smoky, sweet, savory. Mm-hmm. Camouflage-y.
Yeah, it is. That is.
That's good.
And very good.
What's your favorite?
All of it.
You can't say that.
Okay. My favorite.
Your favorite child.
My personal favorite is the ribs. Okay. I take pride in the ribs because mm-hmm. of the process.
How long does it take?
My ribs take about 6 hours.
6 hours.
Yeah.
So when you're planning for a food truck, how do you plan for how many people are going to be eating what?
They give me the play. Lewis give me the diagram. Mm-hmm. And then I then outline the time frame that I need to start and finish. Mm-hmm. So I have two big smokers, and then I let my ribs to smoke at least for 2 hours mm-hmm. before I actually speed cook it.
Your collard greens are like butter.
You like that?
Oh, yeah.
Because sometimes you get like too crunchy.
Right, right.
Or like it's...
Right, they got to be tender.
Yes.
They got to be mm-hmm. tender.
Gosh, that was good. Okay, so if you say your favorite's the ribs, then I just have to, I have to dig in.
You got to go in. Gosh. You got to go in.
All right, Joel.
A plate.
You need a plate?
Oh, here we okay. go. We got a okay. plate. We got okay. a plate here. We've gotten fancier.
Yeah.
There it is. There it is.
Okay. All right, are these the same?
Yes, same.
Okay,
same.
I'll get the smaller one.
There you go. So, there you go.
All right. I can guarantee you the director's going to go right into this camera.
That is.
I knew it. I knew it. Mmm. There's a little kick to it. There's a little heat. Mm-hmm. Oh, that's good. Okay. Take a shot of Thomas. Don't look at me.
I'm not nearly as entertaining.
So you have a couple kids?
Yes, I have five.
Okay.
My daughter is 22. She just graduated Florida A&M. And she's about to be a teacher at Meadowbrook Middle School.
Congratulations.
This school year. My son is 17. Mm-hmm. He's out on the truck with me today. I'm proud of him. He has 14 full ride scholarships. For various different schools around the area of the nation, and he chose to go to Mississippi Valley.
Wow.
In Mississippi.
Proud moment.
Yep. And then my three youngest are my four-year-old, which is my captain. If you go on my Instagram and Facebook, you see I label my kids as rank structure.
Yeah. Of course you do.
You know what I'm saying? So I have my captain. I have my first lieutenant. My first lieutenant is Jeremiah, he's three, and my second lieutenant is the baby, Joa. He's one. So they all have their ranks.
What do you think about dad and his cooking and his food truck? Do you cook a lot at home too?
I do, but I don't. Because I cook all the time. My wife is a great cook as well.
Okay.
So she cooks, she really cooks really well. She the one that came with the mac and cheese recipe.
Did she really?
And the cornbread recipe as well.
Okay, you got mac and cheese.
Yeah, you got to. Right. You got to.
That's good.
But my four-year-old, he's really taken into what I do. Mm. He's mad now he's not at work. He has a uniform. He has camouflage pants.
Stop.
He doesn't play around.
Next podcast.
You've got to bring him.
Yeah.
You've got to bring him. He's all
about. When you come home.
He salutes. His thing is, he always says barbecue, barbecue number one.
Mm-hmm.
That's his thing. Mm-hmm. He has a Powerwood Jeep, because I have a Jeep.
Okay.
And he has to drive his Jeep everywhere.
So he's a mini you, that's for sure.
That for certain.
Mm-hmm.
For certain. For certain.
So what's next? What's next for Brothers-N-Arms?
My goals is to have a few more trucks. I want to my really big goal is to be close to bases, military bases.
Oh, okay.
You know what I'm saying? To provide services, use reserve bases, after duty, just to be a hub where they can come, where they come back for deployment, or they know when they come back to their home base, I can go to Brothers-N-Arms BBQ and get a good meal, mm-hmm. and get a great meal. So that's my dream. Right now we're making leaps and bounds. Every year is not the same. Mm-hmm. I always tell my team I want to be better than I was next year. And that's been going, you know. And I say, if I haven't escalated and exceeded what I did next year, then we need to go back to the drawing board.
Gotcha.
You know what I'm saying? So my team keeps me vigilant. They keep me on my toes. Sometimes I don't want to do what they ask me to do, but that's the thing about teamwork. They see things that you may not see. I see things they're not seeing. We bring our ideas together and put it on the table, and we execute.
Yeah, it makes a good team.
It makes a great team.
Yeah.
You know.
And what's the reaction for you with veterans or other service members when you're actually out there doing your thing, when they see the truck and they come on?
They love it. They love it. They identify it. Anybody that knows somebody, you know somebody that served in the military, you know somebody that served in the military, you identify with veterans.
You know, can you tell before they even say anything? Is it just like a look?
You can look. And then they'll say, Army, I always say this one thing, you sound like you from the Army. You know what I'm saying? You can identify each service, you know what I'm saying? If a devil dog, and that's what we name ourselves, Marines, you know, we got that name from the Germans. If you say, hey, devil dog, I already know that's a Marine. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? We're going to yell and bark at each other, scream, and people that may not understand, but we do.
It's a brother.
You know, the Navy, they have their certain thing, and they come and talk to you, and you just know veterans. Mm-hmm. They have the hats on, they have the haircut, the mannerisms, the way they talk, and they like patronizing the veteran-owned business. You know what I'm saying? So they come to me, they may patronize other trucks, but they identify. Mm-hmm.
Right.
They're familiar with the military, you know what I'm saying? That's why I chose the name Brothers-N-Arms BBQ.
And you're still with them. You're still providing for them.
Absolutely, absolutely. And that's what it's all about.
All right, so where can people find you online?
They can find me at Brothers-N-Arms BBQ on Instagram. They can find me at Brothers-N-Arms BBQ on Facebook. Mm-hmm. They can find me at Brothers-N-Arms BBQ on TikTok. And they can find us at Brothers-N-Arms BBQ, Brothers-N-Arms BBQ.com on our website. And they can all my numbers are on each and every website. I'm very personal with everybody. I like to make sure everybody feels like they're part of the team, and that you're part of the family. And that's what it is. It's a my three F's, and I tell everybody, it's all about family, fun, and fellowship. Each and every time you visit my orange machine called Brothers-N-Arms BBQ, it's about family, fun, and fellowship. I play the 70s funk because that's my daddy's music. It's good barbecue music.
Best.
You know what I'm saying? Before I serve any platinum, they do it today because we had the news station. Yeah. I didn't want to blast the power line.
Oh, come on. You could have. You could have.
But I got to get the 70s funk going.
Okay.
That's when you know the food's good. Yeah. Playing good music, good vibes, good jams. I'm going to check those guys out. And the thing is, I always want to set myself apart from everybody else. So that's what it is, man. If you check out my Instagram and Facebook, you see what I'm all about. And I go live a lot. I talk to the people. Even though I got one viewer on there, somebody's there with me.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, thank you so much for bringing everything in, for talking with us. Good luck with everything.
Yes, ma'am. Yeah. I want to encourage everybody to my philanthropy. I do a lot of philanthropy for different groups, teachers, veterans. My Etsy store, I'm on Etsy. I do a lot of personnel merchandise, shirts, bandanas, keychains, T-shirts, tank tops.
Okay.
A percentage of that proceeds goes back to Semper Fi Foundation. So help me help a veteran. I tell people that all the time. You help me, help them. You know what I'm saying? A lot of these veterans, they had the testing of fortitude to sign a name on the dotted line to support and defend this great country we call the United States of America. So I have to do my due diligence to helping them. I'm talking about from paraplegics, people that suffer from PTSD, just transitioning period, you know what I'm saying? Because that's all they knew. I like helping out my fellow Brothers-N-Arms, man. You know, in any way I can help them, I do it each and every day. I have Marines call me right now, Dawson, how can I do this? Hey, this is how we do it. And that helps me to help them. So I encourage everybody that sees this podcast, help me to help a vet.
Awesome. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, I'm going to keep eating.
Yep. Thank you for listening to Florida Foodie. We'd also like to thank our guest, Joel Dawson.
You can find his business online at brothersinarmsbbq.com. You can also find it on Instagram, Facebook, and TikTok. Be sure to follow Lisa Bell online. Search Lisa Bell News on Facebook and Instagram, or Lisa Bell News 6 on Twitter. You can also find Candace Campos on social media. She's on Twitter. Just search at Candace News 6. And on Facebook, search Candace Campos News 6. On Instagram, search Candace Campos WX. Also, a big thank you to our technical producers, Derek Mosier and Ryan Haley, our post-production audio engineer, Chris Flora, and our director, Bob Myers. I'm the show's producer, Thomas Mates. Please take the time to rate and review us on Apple Podcasts and Spotify or wherever you stream podcasts. And you can find videos of all of our podcasts on clickorlando.com and on YouTube. Just search for Florida Foodie.